By Firebird Productions, the Mega Goat versus the War Dog.
First, I'm going to go to team. Too much focus. Too much atrocity. And reach attack. Our story happens in this city. This great monster trusted of a government. You might not be able to see it, but trust us instead. So the monster left. Wherever a beast came, he hid in a great tunnel where we had planned an evacuation site years ago. He had found and made it his home. Where his evacuation site thought would be the perfect home. Or at least we thought he made a home there because there was a whole bunch of wreckage. He did. He stayed in the ocean. Who knows why that goat liked the ocean? I mean, it's a goat. What? I would have that too. But then I learned that the Mega Goat was a descendant of Mobzilla. A great treacherous beast that lived in the seas. Since the Mega Goat would go up, was a descendant of him, would love the sea. He came and a great monster came up. Oh, water. He grabbed his sword and struck the beast right out in our great city. The beast ran, but he knew it would come back. Just a mega goat. Oh, ghostless. Became scared for our city. Went after the great beast. And the great ghost of our land. The beast ran. To the mountains of our queen. Fell down the cliff, smacked right business of helping people start businesses. He ran. He started to run. He knew the monster wasn't done. Two knows where it went, but the fence of the Gotar found him and struck him every single time he could. Gotar found a weakness. Something weird today called Skulk. A Skulk sensor found. Brought it back to the city. And he found more Skulk underground. Skulk shrieked in a barn. Hope that the Gotar would not come. And if it did, we would be prepared. Gotar stayed there for hours, holding his mind. Finding a herd of great whites trapped in a crack and two krakens. And even sea serpents. And a few pretty large seaweed forests. Megagoat. The water coming into the sea. Nothing was impossible. The water wanted to come to the sea. Why would it come to any neutral habitat? Finally killed the war dog and returned the watery depths below. But he knew that a monster returned soon. Something great.
Okay. And as someone passed through the screen, the mega goat went through the sea.
It was hard to realize what time it was. It was morning time. So the mega goat came up to the sea to show them he had gained the warning. What is now a block of skunk, a defeated piece that could not be defeated alone. So none who ever came to a city dared cross the mega goat.
Gently!
Australian.
The mega goats did right up the lighthouse every night. She came up to the rich people place on Hoosman Avenue and tried to jump on top of the lighthouse many times, but failed each one. Two megalodons came through once in a while. Then sometimes they die. No surprise. For the megagoat was dangerous. He needed a good home. So he found a way to bring light down there. He made a sea lantern with glowing crackings down below. The watery depths no one could explain alone. So he lit up his little cabin with lights that glowed and made the glow crackings happier. He loved to see those glow crackings glow. But he wondered at last, when will I meet? When will I see the citizens in my knee again? He realized there was most likely no reason that he'd ever have to go to the surface again. Unless somehow he would need air. So he didn't think he'd ever have to go up. But he felt something was wrong the next day. As if another monster came to play. A great megalodon saw through the seas and its great whites, scared easily. Great whites might be big, though megalodons are bigger. It was raining easily, so the water was getting cooler. The islanders weren't surprised to see that the giant monster was nigh. About what had happened. Sweet swam towards the surface with a big surprise waiting. Apparently, the second he stepped on land, they gave him a toy of fire land. Somehow someone stopped it from raining. But the second it did, he started playing. Fire came. Danger came. Skyscrapers were broken by fire. Fire came all around. Thanks to that megagoat. He found fire. Fire was a dangerous source of power. All the humans fled the towns and the cities they had lived in forever. Every street was burnt. Even the mayor's office had fire. You couldn't get close to it, it was surrounded by it. Fire was in every direction. The megagoat was banished. He didn't know what he was doing. The people wanted him to do it. They wanted to get him gone. They fled to the millionaire mansion. He set fire there too. The place burned down. Every fire department in half the city came. There, their work cut out for them. Fire sleeps on fire. Giant fires. They wanted him to burn one more thing. the lighthouse, the city's landmark. So he burnt it. He burnt it down. And once the rubble passed, and once the fire had passed, he brought fire to every street in the city. No one could drive away safely. So somehow someone brought back the rain so that the fire would go away. Huh? He took his toy and the torch. They took everything they had given. The people now want to hate them like a goat. So he swam away back to his cave. The city seems never more. But the next day he learned he could his wish come true when Megalodons brought him a bucket. Giant one big enough to fit in his hand. Landed at the city's cliffs. And poured it with one hand. The city was flooding. Obvious. No one could escape this mass destruction. The rain had not stopped raining since the mega goat's last appearance. Then they were right. The mega goat had done this. He flooded that place so much you could barely see it. The millionaire's club got a taste of soggy wet. Under the water. Your watery grave. Some had said to be in the tallest building to survive that. Most said it was the biggest and most devastating flood of a year. The water was growing. No human alive was safe on that island. Even the city hall was flooded. Most people thought it was coincidence. And at the very top of these floors, you could have survived. Wondered, did the Megagoat really do this to them? What had they ever done to him? And then they remembered their plan. Did they fire to him? He thought, well, the citizens were mad that they had done it. Out of the mega goat's sight. If you wanted to survive, you had to be out of the city before the mega goat came. No motorcycles. Not even other monsters have lived. What city more than it's ever seen flooding into a safe spot. The mega goat is now a million. At first, she thought of as a friend, but in the end, the mega goat was a treacherous, evil fiend. So he went back to the watery depths, thinking about what he had just done. Felt disappointed, felt sad. So he swam as far away as he could. Thought a plan. He swam and swam for days and days. Not stopping once to look back what he had done. As he kept swimming, he kept thinking, what would have happened if he didn't do it? Two megalodons joined him on it. A megalodon who followed him for a second. And they kept following him. Felt happy. But then they saw. So once in the watery place, he started